Hello everyone, welcome to Python tutorials. Myself Sampreet Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. We'll continue a previous video about inheritance in Python. So at the end of this video, you'll be able to write a Python script in object-oriented programming style. In the previous video of inheritance, we had seen how to implement single inheritance, multiple inheritance, and multi-level inheritance. In this video, we will go through some hands-on session of creating or understanding how to create hierarchical inheritance and hybrid inheritance. So let's go on to the session. So to create, or what is hierarchical inheritance? When more than one derived classes are created from a single base class, then this type of inheritance is called hierarchical inheritance. So the example we are going to see is, we have a parent as a base class, and this base class will have two child classes, that is two derived classes. So let's create a base class, say class parent, and this will have, let's take a simple function, say function one, which will print this function is of parent class. Okay, now we'll have a derived class, class say child one, which will inherit parent class. Okay, now this class will have a function, say define a function, function 2, and this will print this function is of child 1 class. Okay, so this particular print statement is just for the understanding of how the objects are accessing functions of different classes. So now we'll have a second derived class, that is class child 2. This will also inherit parent class. So see here both child 1 and child 2 are inheriting a single parent class. Okay, single parent class. So this will have a function, say function 3, which will print this function is of child 2 class. Okay, now once we have created a hierarchical inheritance by inheriting a single parent class into both the derived classes, we'll have to see how the objects actually work. So I'll create two objects, obj1 and obj2. So obj1 will be an object of child 1 class, whereas obj2 will be an object of child 2 class. Now with the help of first object, that is obj1, I'll try to access function 1 and function 2, that is of its own class. Okay, function 2. Okay, and with the help of obj2, I'll again access function 1 and function 3. Okay, so function 3 is the function of its own class. Okay, so let's run this. Now here you can see that object 1 can also access parent class and object 2 can also access parent class, as they are inheriting the parent class separately. Okay, so if I try to access function 2 with the help of the second object, say function 2, this will generate an error. It will not have an access to that particular class. Okay, so see attribute error, child 2 instance has no attribute called function name. Okay, so this is an example of hierarchical inheritance. Now moving forward to the last type of inheritance, that is hybrid inheritance. So hybrid inheritance consists of multiple types of inheritance applied in a single program. So this is called as hybrid inheritance. Let's see an example of hybrid inheritance. So here we'll take a class school, and we'll have a function, say function 1. So this will print function is from class school. Now we'll create a class student, class student 1, which will inherit school, and again we'll have a function. So I'll just define function 2. Okay, and this will print that function is from student 1. Now we'll have another class, class student 2, which will inherit again school, and this will have a function, define function 3, and it will print function is from student 2 class. Now this, tell me what type of inheritance is this. So this is hierarchical inheritance. It has a single parent class and it has a two derived classes. Okay, now we'll create class student 3. Now this class will inherit student 1 and student 2. Okay, this class is inheriting student 1 and student 2, and it will have a function, say function 4, which will print function is from student 3. Yes. Now see, we'll create an object only of this class. So if you see first three classes, it is hierarchical inheritance, whereas if you see this three classes, it is multiple inheritance. Okay, is it clear? So we'll create an object of class 3, or say student 3. Okay, so this should be student 3. Yes, and with the help of this object, you can access obj.function1. Okay, so let's just run this. Okay, so the brackets are missing. Yes, so let's, if I run this, see student 3 is accessing function 1. So in spite of having function student 1 and student 2 inherited, it can also access school, because school is the parent class of student 1 and student 2. So try to answer this question, that suppose B is a subclass of A. To invoke the constructor method of A from B, what the line of code should be written? So is A, B, C, or D? What is the possibility, or which is the option that is right to access or invoke instructor of method A from B? So yes, A is the correct option. Why to invoke the constructor of method A from B? Either the following should be written, that is A dot constructor, that is calling itself constructor, or to use a super method from the second class, that is a derived class. Okay, so now many a times it is required that you don't need some members to be accessed by the class. Okay, so to have that, we can restrict the access of the variables by the derived class or child class. So we can make some of the instance variables of the parent class as private. Okay. So let's see an quick example. So class C. Okay. So it will have self.c is equals to 21, and we have self.underscore_c d. So if you want to make a variable private, you have to use double underscore, that is 42. We'll just give some values. Now we'll have class d which inherits c, and we'll try to define a constructor. Okay, define a constructor which will have self dot e is equals to say 84, and c dot we'll call the constructor init. It will have self. So yes, this particular value is to be given in a constructor. Okay. So now if I try to print the value of d using the object of class d, so obj is equals to d, and using this print obj dot d, which is an attribute of c class which is private, it will return you an error that d instance is not an attribute of d. Okay, so this is how we can create private variables. These are some references I have used to create this video. Thank you.